Thank you, Sue Ann, and we're joined this morning with Ambler County's favorite handyman, my pleasure, Stuart London.
Cam, good morning. How are you?
Good. Good to see you, bud.
I like the glasses.
Yeah, you know, it's a disguise, I guess.
I almost didn't recognize you.
Hey, it's a little cold out there.
The weather is changing, and so we're here to talk about a couple things. You know, I try to always focus on preventative maintenance and safety. So the first thing I'd like to talk about with cold weather coming, and this storm that we're looking at right now is a warmer storm, but it's going to be getting cold, insulating the pipes. So this is basic pipe insulation. This is half-inch wall, and that means the thickness is a half-inch thick.
Sure.
And if you grab that piece of copper, and what you would do is spread the pipe, you would wrap the insulation around it, and then you can remove the
for the adhesive.
The glue, the adhesive. Right. And normally we find that this adhesive doesn't always hold, so that you want to put some tape or zip ties around that and insulate the pipes. Upcountry, this is probably not thick enough. Now, we're realizing this is a different diameter pipe.
Right. And
this is 3/4 inch wall. Right. So it's a much thicker. I'm trying to see. There we go. Now, so you can see the differences in thickness on those two items. Mm-hmm. So the thicker pipe. The last thing I do sometimes in real cold areas is I'll put the thin wall on, and then I'll get something that's really large, and I'll double wrap it. Insulating your pipes will not guarantee that you won't have a freeze, but it's a very good preventative measure.
Right.
Along with that idea is winterizing your house is preventative maintenance. If you're going away for the holidays, then what's going to happen? We're going to leave your pump on. You're going to leave everything on. No neighbor to come and watch and check things out, so might not be a bad idea to shut off the breaker at the well or shut off
the master
water main,
disconnect, right.
Just so that if you're gone and something does happen, instead of water flooding for hours and days, just whatever happens, whatever was in the water heater or the toilet would go out. So another thing on the preventative maintenance side, you know what this is for?
Washing machine.
Exactly. So before we go away, we should be looking at the washer and take a quick peek at the hoses. Oftentimes, we'll see signs of corrosion. We may see bulges. This is just a beat-up old hose. These are available at Lowe's, Jackson True Value, just about anywhere, and they even have some super high-pressure ones. If your hoses are more than 3-4 years old, preventative maintenance, get that done, get it taken care of. Also, while you're looking around the house, look at the water heater. Your water heater, according to code, needs to be strapped. Two straps, top third and bottom third. This is a package with steel straps. They also have nylon straps. They all meet code, okay? Plumber's tape, which is that metal tape with all the little holes in it, it's about that wide, doesn't meet code.
Right.
So not a proper item. Again, looking at the water heater, we're looking for things, corrosion. Here's a, now obviously that was in there for a while, and that's pretty bad looking, but the green on that pipe, that's a sign of acidic water, okay? We take a look at this piece of copper. Here's, again, a sign that white section on the pipe is a sign that there could be a possible leak. And one other item that I brought for us to look at. Alan, can you get that? Do you see the green?
Right. And that's a leak there, too.
And there was a tiny little leak, which is why this item was replaced. So winterizing the pipes, turning breakers off, shutting water off before we leave the home for extended periods. And then, of course, with that cold, wet weather, we want to think about safety. So we've talked about grab rails in the past. Okay. Grab rails can also be put on the outside of the house. Okay. So if there's an area of the house.
The stairs or somewhere.
On the stairs, anything of that nature. And of course, this is an 18-inch bar. They've got them in 24-inch, 32, 48 inches. So a grab bar like this is a good investment. And, of course, they can be mounted at bathrooms, at toilets, and inside of showers as well.
We spoke about this before. Anybody can buy a grab bar, but it's properly installing it and making sure that it's either in a stud or toggled in correctly, because when you're relying on this to hold your weight up, sheetrock and a couple of deck screws aren't going to do it.
Correct. And I'm glad you remember that, because, as a matter of fact, if you call, if we did that, we actually showed the anchor, and you leaned on it, and it all came right out.
Right.
So these are things we want to be looking at. These other items that I've got here, these are just to show different types of materials that cold water is brought into the house. Normally, PVC is not the standard, although from a well to the house, PVC can be used. Oftentimes in replacement, I use this product. This is called PEX, and it's a flexible water line. So if you notice all the different things I can do with that, I can make a repair on a pipe at one end. So where my right hand is, we would do a sweat, and then we would go finish it out at the point where it finally needs to be serviced.
Speaking with Stuart London, local handyman here, Amador County. If somebody wants to think about this type of preventative maintenance, it's going to be far less expensive and far easier than the broken pipe in the future.
Absolutely.
And I think that's sort of the message you're putting out here.
Yeah. Look things over, and the homeowner can at least look at the water heater. They can look around the house for signs, things like that, and then give us a call. We can come out and take a look.
Okay, Stuart, thanks for coming in the studio.
Cam, great seeing you
again. Good to see you, and we're going to switch it over to Sue Ann.